Apple's G5 is the very last generation of PowerPC-powered Apple hardware. It's also the first one that had a 64-bit CPU on board. This leaves us with a bit more options than the previous generations like the G4 iBook I showed in an earlier video. This iMac G5 was sold to me for just 5 euros. A steal, isn't it? Well, of course it had an issue. As the previous owner stated, it didn't start. Did I get lucky again with an iMac that just needed a fresh OS installation? Let's find out. To answer my own question, nope. This one didn't turn on. At all. I peeked inside and it actually looked quite good. Searching the internet, I found that power supplies of these things tend to break quite often. So I searched for a replacement and found a used one for just 20 euros in France. So I took the gamble and ordered one. Let's open it up again. Release the screws holding the power supply in. Disconnect the most annoying connector in the history of computing. And get the old unit out. The labels on both units don't match, but apart from that they look the same. The machine is dead anyway, let's just plug it in and see what happens. Nah. Yeah! It doesn't boot, but that was expected as the previous owner told me that the hard disk was cleared. I could install macOS, but I was planning to give Adélie another try. Adélie is an interesting Linux distribution that provides images for ARM, PowerPC and x86 platforms, both 32 and 64-bit. Today I'm getting PPC64, as my new G5 should be able to run that. Pick the desktop distribution and choose XFCE for a desktop, since this machine will probably benefit from having a lightweight environment. Since I haven't mastered booting Linux from USB on open firmware systems like this one, I've burned it to a CD. There she goes. Booting from CD goes pretty slow. And it's not very responsive either. About as unusable as it gets. Opening a console, which I apparently started off camera, took minutes. And every command just takes longer than it should. This is real time. Maybe it just needs some more memory. 265 megabytes is pretty tight nowadays. Let's open it up again. Remove the old 265 megabyte module and add these two 1 gigabyte ones. This seems to be the maximum this machine can handle, but I don't have any bigger modules to try anyway. Well, boot time improved and it's a lot snappier than before. Let's just open a console again and start partitioning the drive. Wait, do we have the full 2 gigabytes available by the way? Alright! Okay, let's create a partition layout and start installing. No partition map exists. Initialize one? Doesn't seem like anything is happening. What does regular fdisk have to say? A GPT partition map with two Windows partitions. Maybe just pick an old school DOS layout and see if Mac fdisk understands that. No partition map exists. Okay, but maybe initialize works now? Well, it didn't, so I did a lot of swearing off camera, but then I accidentally figured it out. Within Mac fdisk, I followed by an enter does nothing until you press enter again. Why? Alright, we've got our Apple partition map. I created a boot partition and did it wrong, but didn't notice that before after installing. So after a failed boot, I found the issue. Type C, remove the partitions and did it again. formatted them, and ran the installer. It didn't boot right away, but that's because we need to tell Open Firmware where to boot from. Got into Open Firmware by pressing Alt-Option-OF. Out of focus, again, sorry. Type setenv boot device, hd:2,grub/grub, followed by just boot, and off she goes. Cool, again we've got not only XFCE like expected, but KDE as well. You guys can't really see it because it's too small, but trust me, it's there. This system only has mini VGA out. I've got quite a few converter cables, but that one I don't have. I guess it's a good idea to get one if I ever make a follow-up about this G5 or my G4 iBook, which has the exact same video output. Anyway, here's XFCE in all its glory. We only have the NetSurf browser, which is quite nice, but incapable of showing any modern social media sites like Facebook or YouTube. Look, my new website works! As expected, it doesn't show the YouTube video on it though. Sound's not working, because packages like the Pulse Audio Sound Server, or any sound server for that matter, are missing. After installing that, I rebooted just to be sure. And couldn't log in anymore. The system just gets unresponsive. I have a mouse pointer, but that's it. The keyboard doesn't seem to respond to anything. I can't even get into another TTY to kill my session. Pressing the power button shortly doesn't do anything either, so my only option is to press the power button long enough to turn it off. I even reinstalled, but this seems to happen each time. KDE still works though. So it's some weird XFCE thing, not sure what it is exactly. Still no sound, but after fiddling for a while, it seems that the internal speakers are simply mistaken to be headphones. After enabling the headphone output,
front, left, front, right.
Where on my 32-bit G4 we didn't have the ability to install another browser, on this G5 we do. There's Firefox ESR in Adélie's repositories. Let's see how usable that is. It does load my website and it even shows the YouTube video on it, but it's not great. It's not much better on YouTube itself. It doesn't load the Pico 8 game on my site either. To be honest, I'm a bit disappointed about this. The GPU is detected and using the Nouveau driver, but Firefox isn't using it. Some games? SuperTux runs great, so that's a win. Trigger Rally isn't playable at native desktop resolution and runs okay windowed at 640x480. But it doesn't really look right, does it? There aren't a lot of other games on Adélie's repository to try. No SuperTux card, no Tux Razor, mostly simple KDE games. By the way, we don't have Wi-Fi either because of the dreaded Broadcom BCM4306 card in here. Would the online experience have been a bit better, I might have taken the time to try and fix that, but yeah. I guess that's it for today. Do you think another distro or OS would be a better option? Or is this G5 only interesting for retro enthusiasts? I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please consider subscribing for more. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.